Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. With me today is Jason Reid, CEO at Fortitude Gold. Jason, good to see you. How are you?
I'm good, Christine. How are you?
I'm great. Thanks for asking. Fortitude Gold put out its full year 2021 results this week. Some record numbers we're seeing here. Tell us how you performed.
Yeah, we had a great year. We had a record gold production. We actually beat our increased outlook throughout the year. And that's in large part to do with the fact that our deposit is so high grade that it's actually outperforming the model. And that's unique in the space. So it's very exciting. And yeah, we had, you know, records all across the board. It was a good year.
How do you think you performed compared to your peers?
Well, we have a slide on our corporate presentation where we compare ourselves in 2021 to the GDXJ, which is made up of mostly junior miners and some mid-tier miners. And when you look at their performance over 2021, their share price moved from the upper left to the lower right on their stock charts, whereas ours went from the lower left to the upper right. And we outperformed our peers, hands down. And in large part, that's because we have a dividend aspect to our company in which we deliver a substantial monthly dividend.
You are expecting record free cash flow in 2022. How do you plan to reinvest that?
Good question. Well, right now we have great treasury at $40 million, and we're looking to build our next mine called Golden Mile, and we're getting close to reaching that threshold. We believe we have the treasury to build that mine, which is great. But we also are looking in 2022 going into record free cash flow. So we expect to add to that treasury. And as far as deployment, you know, we're trying to get another drill for exploration. We have two at site, and we continue to drill aggressively. We're looking to build another mine, and then obviously we continue to pay the dividend. So we plan to do all that while hopefully building our treasury.
So how soon do you think you can make a development decision on Golden Mile?
We're very close. We're fine-tuning some of the CapEx numbers. We're looking at the financial side of things. Yeah, I believe by mid-year, if not sooner. So that's coming up.
And you've also given production guidance for 2022. Share us the details there.
Yeah, we're looking at another 40,000 ounces. And in large part, we're just holding a steady state. We could actually bump that up if we chose to do so, but we're not, because we're looking at building another mine and we need time to get it permitted, built, and commissioned. So we're holding the 40,000 ounces for the time being, and then ultimately make the transition into Golden Mile. But let's assume for the moment we do all that, we're pushing our mine life out to 2028. So that is getting closer to that 10-year mark where shareholders don't reward companies for that, anything beyond that. So then we'd be looking to at ways to increase production. And we have some ideas on how we could do that as well.
All right. Before I let you go, Jason, anything else you want to share about the full year for investors who are watching today?
I think the big focus, in my opinion, is that this deposit is outperforming the model. And it's one of the highest grade open pits operating today. And so we are very fortunate to have that. And then we're also looking at making the transition over into Golden Mile, which is north of a gram. And most every mining company wants a open pit heap leach north of a gram as well. So that's excellent grade. So I think my big focus and what I'm very excited about is that all our properties have surface or near surface high grade gold. And so we're sitting in a real strong position to be in Nevada producing for a very long time.
Congrats again on these results, Jason. Good to see you. Thanks so much.
Thanks, Christine. Have a good day.